Oh my goodness, you guys ready for your next comic? Yes, keep that going for Janine, Brito.
Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for coming to the show. This is my survival tactic for the next 4 years, is just to dress like a senator's son. That way when Trump starts to round us up, I can be like, oh no, I'm Paul Ryan's nephew! And I'll live. It's a tough time. It's a tough time we're living in. I'm also in a tough time personally. I was celibate for a while. I abstained from dating or anything for a spell. It was difficult. It was. I'm not saying I got lonely, but I did eat Activia out of a fleshlight. You know? Just to remember what once was in the before time. I usually went strawberry or peach. I always thought about Jamie Lee Curtis. It was a real special moment for me. Some of you are like, flashlights? Home Depot. Look up fleshlight when you get home. You'll be quite surprised. No, I took a break from dating because I needed to get my mind right. I realized that I have horrible taste in women. Usually, my type is just a demon in a skin suit, just like a bad monster human person. Like, it's weird. Once I came out and I started dating, I realized I'm not attracted to women that remind me of my mother. Instead, I am attracted to the women that my father dated after he left my mother, which is real messed up. But no, my last relationship that I just got out of before this celibacy spell, I was in an abusive relationship. And people tense up when I talk about that. Lesbians were not the go-to thing you think of in that scenario. Like, lesbians were like the fleece of human sexuality. Like, we're real soft, warm, dependable. You take us camping. We're not the face of domestic abuse. And you wouldn't expect it in this direction either. Like, she was very femme, and I always look like a junior executive from Mad Men. Like, I always look like my hobbies are just drinking scotch and shaking a woman to calm her down. Like, come on, Deborah! You know, like, I own undershirts covered in barbecue stains. Like, if anyone was gonna do yelling, you'd think it'd be me. But no, we were very progressive and flipped the gender roles there. But we were together for a long time. It was a very complicated situation. Those situations often are. I loved her very much. Also, the sex was fantastic, and it kept me trapped. And that has happened several times. I feel very betrayed by my clit. I'm like, come on, Manny Pacquiao! That's what I call it, because it's small but powerful. No, I name all of my stuff after men. Like, this is Manny Pacquiao. I name my breasts Johnny Depp and Captain Jack Sparrow because they look alike, but this one's a little drunk and droopy. It just feels right. But I think it took me a while to figure out healthy dating because I came out pretty late for someone my age. I came out essentially the tail end of college because I didn't want to have fun, so I waited till the party was wrapping up, and then I came out. And when I did, like, all of my friends and family were like, ah, yeah, we fucking know. Which was weird to me because I thought I was hiding it pretty well back then. Like, back then I had real long hair. My favorite color was pink. Thought that would cover it. It did not. And I tried to figure out what gave me away. And I realized that up until that point, I never talked about sex or dating. And then when I did, I way overcompensated. And the first instance of this was when I was 12. I realized all my friends were getting into dating and boys and stuff. And I was like, oh snap, gotta catch up. So what I did is I went to the mall and I bought a Thunder from Down Under nudie man calendar. You know, like we all did at 12. That's a normal thing for a child to do. First up, what's up with that guy that sold me that? I hope he's on a list somewhere. Fingers crossed. But I remember I wouldn't let the dude put it in a bag. I just made him hand it to me so I could walk around the mall just like, check out what the J-Dog likes. She was like, real. And I showed it to my mom when I got home, which is so creepy. But I was like, Mama, come to the foyer. And my mom comes out of the living room and she sees her 12-year-old daughter holding this naked stripper dude calendar. And my mom gives me this look that's just like, eh, which said two things. It said, one, I don't believe you. And two, no straight woman under the age of 75 is into this. What the fuck is going on, Blanche Devereaux? Like, what is... Because, like, it's true. I have been to both bachelor and bachelorette parties. I have observed straight people in that habitat. The Magic Mike movie franchise is a lie. Because, like, straight men watching female strippers, like, there are men in the room legitimately being aroused. But, like, straight women with male strippers, nobody's getting turned on. Most of you guys are like, oh, he's a cutie patootie. But, like, it's mostly just like, oh, my God, Kathy, this is so out of character. Like, bonding experience for you guys. Like, there's no woman sitting in a dark booth at a Chippendale show just like, oh, God, I can't wait to get home so I can just, There's none, not a single one. And if there is, it's a lady who lives in the woods and has a coat made out of raccoons. It's a crazy mountain woman who has those thoughts. This is a great show. Stand-up, it's still like a very male, very straight-dominated field. And I remember I was hanging out with some guys in a green room after a show, and they were all bragging about their escapades. And one gentleman started talking about a Tinder date that ended very well. He said it ended with a standard blowjob. And he kept saying it over and over again, just standard blowjob. And I became livid. Standard blowjob? Are you fucking kidding me right now? Let's break down what goes into a blowjob, shall we? You're taking a penis where pee comes out of and putting it into your mouth where your taste buds are, hanging out next to balls and a butthole, just like really sticking it out until the other person climaxes into your head and you decide where to go from that. Standard blowjob? Fuck you, sir. I don't care if it's the worst blowjob you've had in your life. The only way to describe any blowjob is to say, an angel knelt before me and performed miracles! Like, get up a Hamlet skull. Put a little drama into it, you know? Like, I've received blowjobs wearing a strap-on. I can't even feel that shit. And I'm like, this is amazing! So just appreciate what you have, gentlemen. That's gonna do it for me. Thank you all so much for coming out. Welcome back your wonderful host, Zach!
Keep it going for Janine Brito. An angel on her knees. An angel.